technology and the way we live doesn't care about my opinion or my feelings, and it doesn't care about yours either. And so you can walk around Earth and judge, oh, it's so sad that all these kids can't communicate because they're on the phone anymore. And you could talk about a day and age when it was simpler and nicer and all this. Nobody gives a fuck. And if you don't adjust to the reality of the situation, you will be completely left behind. Too many people are executing or hoping or trying to figure out how to live in a world that used to be or the way they wish it was versus attacking the reality of the world. And here is the reality of the world, my friends. The cell phones that you're all holding right now or in your pocket are the remote controls of our society. They are the single most important thing in the world. There's nothing close. Whatever you want to happen in life, you first need somebody's attention and then you need to tell them about it. It was called the newspaper, the television, and the radio. Now it's called a blog, a vlog, or a podcast. It's the same thing. Nothing's changed except one thing. Your attention is moving to a new place and leaving an old place. I'm making this very simple, very black and white, very fucking basic. If you do not spend next year completely obsessing over how you become successful on Facebook and Instagram, you will be disproportionately less likely to win. The ad product on those two platforms are disproportionately underpriced, and that is where you should be trading. You are grossly underestimating what's happening right now. 98% of people are grossly underestimating how good it is right now. You will look back at this talk, all my content during this era. Why am I producing so much content during this era? Why am I flying around the entire world over and over speaking to this subject? It's because I know what I'm talking about right now is gonna go away. And I think we can all agree, I'm not hedging up here right now. I'm desperately trying to force this down your fucking mouth, right? You heard it, and I believe that 95% of you will not do anything about it. You'll do enough to make it feel like you did something. And you will regret not going all in. How many people here play poker? Good. I don't, but if you do, when you have the best hand, it's a good idea to go all in. I'm a great entrepreneur, but I think I'm even better at consumer behavior and psychology. It's who I am, it's why a lot of you follow me, because when you cut me down, you see that I'm pushing positivity and a whole lot of other things that matter and trying to get people to do it the right way, be patient, do the right thing, da-da-da-da-da-da. The thing that people have not wrapped their head around is that this takes a lot of work, like a lot. If you wanna make $100,000 a year and like doing it, and it's on your terms, and it's your life, it takes a lot of work. And it takes a lot of smart work. You've never met anybody in your life who hasn't worked their face off for a long time that's built something significant. It may seem that it happened fast because they're 27, but maybe they've been hustling since they were 13 in a different way that gave them 14 years of experience to be a winner in that game. Everybody's so worried about tomorrow that it doesn't allow them to see what's actually happening here. And that's why I always recommend people spending time with older people, retirement home. I'm a big fan because you get to see regret and resentment up close, and it starts to help you frame up a life. In life, we're all born with either an advantage or disadvantage. We either started with too much or we started with too little, and then basically, you know, your internal fortitude decides if that was good or bad. You know, listen, man, to be very honest with you, I'll give you the answer. You have no choice. That's how. What's the alternative? When you have a setback, what are you gonna sit there and say, it was your granddad and your dad? I mean, you know that's not true. It's why you have so many wins, right? So just practice. I just kept practicing blaming myself for everything. Now I just default into it. I think you just have no choice, brother.
Listen,
I'll leave you guys with this. Doing anything that doesn't ring true down your entire operating system and soul because you think you need to do it based on somebody's advice that you admire or because you have short-term pain in your life is never going to work. It has never worked, it doesn't work, and it's just better to wrap your head around enjoying the short-term pain, and I mean that. Like, the process, listen, the Rocky movies that are good is when it's shitty. Not when he's in the fancy mansion. If you're sitting with some adversity right now, it's yours, right? No matter what your adversity is, we all have it. And so, please, please wrap your head around what we're actually doing here. And more importantly, if you were smart enough to be here today, and I mean this, the fact that you came here today puts you so far ahead of everybody else, and I hate knowing for fact that so many of you are gonna give up your advantage because you like hearing me say it and you like the way it feels, but then you leave and you don't do anything about it. So please, Brisbane, do me a favor. Go do something about this talk today. I implore you, it will change the course of your career. Thank you.